Did you know that you can do a clean install of Windows without a USB flash drive? Most people think they're stuck with an in-place upgrade if they don't have a flash drive. But I'm about to show you a little known method that actually works really well. In the next few minutes, you'll learn the exact step-by-step process that I use to perform clean Windows installations without any external media. No USB drives needed, no complicated tools or external software, and it works whether your PC meets the Windows 11 system requirements or not. So here's what we'll cover. How to create installation media directly on your hard drive or solid state drive using only built-in Windows tools. The simple command that bypasses Windows 11 hardware restrictions completely. And some tips for setting up Windows 11 without being forced into a Microsoft account. I'll also show you a simple trick that keeps your start menu on Windows 11 completely clean. No ads, no bloatware, just a fresh Windows experience. In this guide, I'll be installing Windows 11, but the installation method I'm about to show you works on both Windows 10 and Windows 11. I've also made this guide as thorough and beginner-friendly as possible so that even non-tech-savvy users will be able to perform a clean Windows installation without a USB flash drive. Let me show you exactly how it works. Now the first thing we need to do is create space for our Windows installation files. This might sound complicated, but Windows actually has some built-in tools that makes this really easy. Let me show you. So first off, we need to create a partition for the Windows installation media. To do that, right-click on the Start button and then select Disk Management. In the Disk Management window here, you can see that I only have one drive in this computer, and the drive only has one data partition. Now, if you have multiple drives in your computer, they will all show up here. And here's something important to know. If it's a completely new drive that you connected to your computer that you want to install Windows on, you may need to initialize it first and then create a partition on it. Here's a quick example of how you can do that on screen now. But since this is the only drive I have, I'll need to use the C drive. If you have multiple drives, feel free to use whichever one you like, as long as it has at least 10 gigs of free space. Once you've identified the partition that you'll be using for the Windows installation media files, you need to right-click on the partition and then select the shrink volume option. In the next window here, you need to enter the amount of space that you want to shrink the partition by. I recommend that you enter 10,000, as that'll be 10 gigabytes and it'll be enough space for all of the Windows installation files. Once that's done, you can just click on shrink. Now you should also have a block of unallocated space like I have here. But here's where it gets important. We need to format the space correctly, or else we'll have trouble identifying the partition with the Windows installation files on it, and the installation might not work properly. So first, select this partition and then right-click on it. Next, choose this option that says New Simple Volume so we can create a new partition. In the wizard window here, you can just continue clicking on Next, as using the defaults for these options should be fine. But once you get to the format screen here, I highly recommend changing the volume label from New Volume to something more recognizable, like Windows Installer Media or something like that. After that, you can just click on Next and then you can click on Finish in the final screen. Now that we have the new partition created, we can move on to the next step, which is downloading the Windows ISO file. Now, like I mentioned before, I'll be installing Windows 11 in this guide, so that's why I'll be downloading the Windows 11 ISO file. If you want to install Windows 10, you can just download the Windows 10 ISO file, and I have other videos on this channel showing you how you can download the Windows 10 ISO file, and I'll link those down in the description below. So to download the latest Windows 11 ISO file, you can visit the Windows 11 downloads page, and then you can just scroll down to the Windows 11 disk image section here, then select the Windows 11 Multi-Edition ISO file from the drop-down menu here, and then click on Download Now. On the next page, select your preferred language, and then click on Confirm. Then finally, on the last page, just click on the Download button to start the download. The download could take a while depending on the speed of your internet connection, but once it's finished, just navigate to where the ISO file is saved on your computer. For me, it's the Downloads folder. Now we need to mount the ISO file so we can get the Windows installer files. So to do that, just right-click on the ISO file and then select the Mount option. The File Explorer window should then automatically display the ISO file contents, which is the files we need to install Windows. So now, just select all of these files in this mounted folder and then copy it. Next, navigate to this PC and then open the Windows Media partition you created earlier. Now, you can just paste the copied files here. Once it's done copying, you can navigate back to this PC and then unmount the ISO file. Now, just a quick tip here for the advanced users. If you include an auto unattended file, or also called an answer file, like the one I created with unattended winstall, in the root of the partition that contains the Windows installation files, the Windows setup will actually read it and apply it if you install Windows like this. But I'll create a separate video on that in the future, but I just thought I'd mention it to you guys that might want to use an answer file when you do a clean install of Windows like this without a USB flash drive. Okay, so now that we have all of the required files, it's time to restart into recovery mode. Now, there are a few ways to do this. One of the simplest ways is to just hold down the left shift button on your keyboard when you restart the computer, but there is also a way to do it manually via the Windows settings, so let me show you how to do that. So to access the advanced startup options, you can start by opening Settings and then navigate to System. Next, you want to find the Recovery section and then select it, and then you'll find the advanced startup option here. So once you have this option, you can just click on Restart Now, and then you should also see a prompt to save your work. Just click on Restart Now again, and then it will obviously restart your computer. So once it's restarted, you should see these advanced startup or recovery options. This is where we can access the command prompt, so we can start the clean install of Windows. And this is also where we'll be able to bypass the Windows 11 system requirements, but I'll show you that specific command in just a moment. So once you see these recovery options, you need to select the troubleshoot option, then select advanced options, and then finally you can select command prompt. If your user account has a password, you might need to enter it here. If it doesn't have a password, you might just need to click on OK or press enter. But for me, it didn't prompt for any password and it just opened command prompt directly. So the first thing that we need to do now, which is very important, is identify the drive letter of the partition that contains the Windows installer files. This step usually confuses a lot of people because the drive letters can change when you're in recovery mode. But let me show you how you can identify the correct drive letter. So a really easy way you can do this is to just type in Notepad and then press Enter. That's going to open Notepad here in the recovery environment. Next, just click on File and then Open. And then a dialog window should open, prompting you what file you want to open. Now here you can just navigate to this PC, as that's going to show you all of the drives. And then you'll also easily be able to see the drive letter of the partition that contains the Windows installer files. You can even open it to verify that it is indeed the Windows installation files. So I've identified that the drive letter of the partition containing the Windows installer files is C. So here in the command prompt window, I'll just type C colon and then press enter, and then it'll navigate to that partition. Now I can also just run the dir command so that it displays all of the files on that partition, and you should see items like boot, sources, and then most importantly, the setup file. Now at this point, we can start the installation. So to do that, just type setup.exe and then press enter. That'll launch the Windows Setup Wizard so that we can perform a clean Windows installation. Now, if your computer supports Windows 11, you'll be able to continue with the standard Windows installation process here. The computer I'm using to record this video does not support Windows 11, and you'll see the setup prevent me from installing Windows 11 later on. But I'm deliberately doing it this way so that once we get there, I can show you the simplest method to bypass the Windows 11 hardware requirements so you can get it installed on your system. Now the Windows Setup Wizard is pretty simple to use, and in most cases you can just leave these settings on the defaults, but I will give you a quick tip here. If you want to prevent the start menu on Windows 11 from being bloated with ads, change the time and currency format here to English World, then just click on Next. You can change your keyboard settings if needed. I'll just click on Next since it's correct already, and then on the next screen, select the checkbox to agree that your files will be deleted, and then click on Next. On the next screen here, where it asks for a product key, you can just click on the option down here that says I don't have a product key. Then on the next screen, you can select the edition of Windows 11 that you want to install. For me, it'll be Windows 11 Pro, and then you can just click on Next. Now it'll do some checks on your PC to determine if it can run Windows 11, and if it can, you can just continue with the installation process. But like I told you before, this PC does not support Windows 11, and I deliberately did this to show you the simplest way to bypass these hardware checks. So if you also see this screen that says that your PC doesn't meet the Windows 11 system requirements, follow these steps. First, you need to close the current Windows 11 setup wizard. Next, in the command prompt window, you can type setup.exe again, but this time followed by a space, then forward slash, the word product, and then followed by a space, then the word server. So the entire command should look like this, where it says setup.exe, space forward slash product, and then space server. Then you can press enter. It'll launch the same Windows 11 setup wizard again, and you can then go through the exact same steps as I explained before. Now, you might notice that it says it'll install Windows Server here, but don't worry, it's not going to install Windows Server. You'll still be able to choose the edition you want to install. On this screen, once again, just select the option that says I don't have a product key, then just select the edition of Windows you want to install, and then click on Next. Now, this is where it normally does the hardware requirement checks for Windows 11, but it should just skip past that and then prompt you to accept the license terms. So go ahead and do that, and then you'll get to the disk selection screen. Now, this part is very important because it involves deleting partitions, which means you're deleting files and folders that's saved on that drive. So if you have any important information saved on the drive that you'll format, and you haven't copied those files to another drive or saved them in the cloud or at just another location, then you'll need to go and do that first and make sure that your important files are backed up on another location before you continue with this process. But to continue, you should be seeing the partition you created earlier, which contains the Windows installation media. Do not delete that partition, or else you won't be able to install Windows. Now you can go ahead and delete any of the other deletable partitions on the drive that you want to install Windows on. Remember, I only have one drive, that's why it just says disk 0 here on the left. But if you have multiple drives, you'll see them all listed here as disk 1, disk 2, and so on, depending on how many drives you have in the computer. So just be sure that you are deleting the partitions from the correct drive and that you don't accidentally make a mistake. That's all I'm saying. So to delete a partition, just select it and then click on the delete partition button up here. Then you'll need to do that for all of the partitions that you want to delete from that disk until the disk has enough free unallocated space. Then you can just select the unallocated space entry and then click on next. Finally, you'll see the ready to install screen with a summary of what is about to happen. So I'll be installing Windows 11 Pro and I'll be keeping nothing since this is a clean install. Then to start the installation, just click on install. Now the installation can take anywhere from 20 minutes to an hour or more, depending on the hardware of your computer. But once it's finished, you'll be taken to the Windows 11 out of box experience where you can set up Windows for the first time. Now here, I'll also be giving you some very important tips because the standard Windows 11 setup experience can be pretty annoying if you don't want to use a Microsoft account. So if you do want to sign in with a Microsoft account on Windows, you can skip these steps. But for those of you who want to use a local account on Windows 11 like me, be sure to follow along. So the first thing you need to do here is disconnect from the internet. If you have a desktop PC, just unplug the Ethernet cable for now. And if you have a laptop, try putting it on airplane mode or disable the Wi-Fi. Most laptops have combination keys on the keyboard that you can press to do this. Once you're disconnected from the internet, you can select your region if you see it, or you can just click on skip to skip this first screen. Next, we need to open command prompt. To do that, press Shift and F10 on the keyboard. On some laptops, you may have to press Shift, the function key, and F10 together. Once command prompt is open, run the regedit command so you can open the registry editor. Once the registry editor is open, navigate to the following path in the registry. Once you're here, right-click on the empty white space and then create a new DWORD 32-bit value. Then name it bypass NRO, exactly as you can see on screen now. Next, open the value by double-clicking it, then change the value data to 1, and then click on OK. Now you can close the registry editor and the command prompt window. You can change the keyboard layout if needed. I'll just click on yes since it's already correct, and then just skip the next screen as well. And now you should see this option down here that says I don't have internet. Go ahead and click on that. On the next screen, enter a username and continue. If you want to use a password, you can enter it here. If you don't want to use a password like me, you can just leave it blank and then click on Next. Then you'll be able to change the privacy settings. Now, I recommend just disabling all of these, like I'm doing now, and then you can just click on Accept. Now it'll load into the user profile, and then you'll get to the Windows 11 desktop. The first thing to do now is to connect to the internet. So just plug in the Ethernet cable again, and if you have a laptop with Wi-Fi, just enable it again and then connect to the Wi-Fi. If you selected the English World option during the setup like I did, you'll also have a clean start menu just like I have now, but there is something important to do. Open the settings and then navigate to the time and language section. Then click on the region option up here, and then on the next screen, just change the country or region to wherever you are in the world. If you don't do this, some Microsoft apps like the Microsoft Store is not going to work, so it is important to do this if you want to use that. But once that's done, you can close the settings or you can go and check for updates, but those should have started automatically anyway. Now there is one last important thing I want to show you, which might stop you from using this method to install Windows without a USB flash drive. If I open up the disk management window here and we have a look at the disk, you can see that I do have the normal C drive partition, and then I also still have the Windows Installation Media partition that we use to install Windows. But I also have these other recovery partitions and this block of unallocated space. Now the downside of the method I showed you in this video is that there's no way to increase the size of the C drive partition now. The reason for that is because of this recovery partition that's in between the C partition and the other partitions. So even if I delete the Windows Installation Media partition because I want to use that space to expand the C drive, it won't work because of the recovery partition that's in between these two partitions. So if you'll be using this method to install Windows, I suggest that you just keep the Windows Installation Media partition as it is, and then it can also serve as a recovery tool in case your Windows installation crashes. In my opinion, it'll just be the best to do a clean install of Windows from a USB flash drive, since you'll have full control over the partitions on the drive where you want to install Windows. But I do understand that some people just don't own USB flash drives, or the USB ports on their computer might be faulty, and they're looking for the kind of solution that I provided in this video. I've also put together a complete written guide on my website with all of the commands and registry tweaks from this video, and you can find a link to that in the description below. Now that you have a fresh Windows 11 installation, you're probably wondering about the best ways to optimize it for performance and privacy, and I've got a few Windows optimization and customization videos on this channel, which I'll link at the end of this video. But if this method of installing Windows without a USB flash drive was useful to you, do me a favor and please hit the like button and leave a comment with your thoughts down below. But as always, I just want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.